Hey, L3.
What?
Tell me a Star Wars joke.
What's Han Solo's least favorite coffee shop? Jar of the Heart.
Oh, L3.
What?
Nothing. Hey, robot fans. Welcome to the making of the Amazon Voice Services-powered L337, the lead robot from the new Star Wars movie.
Han Solo.
What you're looking at here is the final 3D model used for this project. The STL print files for this model can be found for free on my GitHub page, which is linked in the description to this video. I even included the source 3D Studio Max file for my fellow Max users out there. The only thing I ask in return is if you like this video, click the subscribe button right here. Maybe check out some more videos too. So I think this model is pretty accurate. I actually did two iterations of this. The first was done prior to opening weekend using screenshots I found online, but when I went to the movie and saw it for myself, I noticed a lot of the things that were wrong and I went back and did a version 2, which is what you see here. Starting with the main structural parts, we have the base and the neck. The neck is hollow and it has a little hole in the back down here to run a wire up to the head. At the top there is a mounting structure for the large servo horn of the HS805BB Plus servo, which connects the neck to this internal ring which we will build our head off of. This ring has a mounting structure for the servo as well as a bunch of holes throughout for mounting the rest of our electrical components. I decided to keep all of these additional mounts modular in case there is a balance issue down the line and we need to adjust the weight distribution in the head. As far as functionality, this is a really simple project. Everything is set up here on a breadboard just to show you. The head will be in a rest position like this, pointing down a little bit most of the time. Then when the Amazon Voice Services is triggered, the head will rise up and the lights will come on. This is what it'll look like when L3 is talking and doing all of the Amazon Voice Service stuff. And then when that's done, it returns to its rest position. Right now I'm triggering that functionality with a button, but the real fun will be setting up the Amazon Voice Service to do all that button pushing for me while it's running a traditional Alexa inside the head. My original plan was to use an Amazon Echo Dot mounted inside, which would probably have been a lot cleaner and a lot easier, but with the Echo Dot, I couldn't use L3 as a wake word. I would have had to keep using Alexa or computer or whatever other boring things Amazon lets you use, and I really felt like using L3 as a wake word was the cool factor for this project. So I decided to install an Alexa app on a Raspberry Pi 3 to power this droid. There are a few different versions of this app out there, and some are better than others. The one that allowed all the customization I need was the Amazon Voice Services Device SDK. So in addition to the voice services, I need three features to make this project work. One is the custom L3 wake word. Two is the button pushing capability we mentioned earlier via the GPIO pins on the Pi. And three is locale customization. I'm located in the US, so my voice services default to an American accent. Ideally, I'd like to change this to a British accent to better match the performance done by Phoebe Mary Waller-Bridge. Right. Luckily, these features are readily available on the AVS Device SDK with links and instructions on how to incorporate all of them into the app. I printed a mount for all the components and I installed it onto the updated ring, which I've also painted a little bit. I put everything from the breadboard and the last test onto a more proper circuit board and mounted that to the back. I installed an audio amplifier, which will take the outgoing audio signal from the Pi to this speaker, which is plenty loud. The Raspberry Pi is mounted on top of the servo with this little push fit mount. Normally I'd be very concerned about keeping all my wiring super neat and tidy, but L3 has a ton of wires hanging down from her head, so in addition to some fake decorative wires I'm going to add later, I decided to make all the functional wires part of the final look. Okay, we're ready to test our fully Amazon Voice Services controlled droid here. I added one more feature beyond the three that we've already talked about. You can add a response from the Amazon Voice Services when the wake word is triggered. I thought a very dry what would be really funny, kind of like how L3 is a little bit snarky in the movie. So here, if we test it out, we could say, L3.
What?
What time is it?
It's 1:23 p.m.
L3.
What?
Tell me a joke.
Have you heard the rumor about butter? Never mind. I shouldn't spread it.
Oh, Jesus. Dad jokes aside, this is working pretty well, so now it's time to get all the skins painted and finished. Here you can see them in various stages of the finishing process. I'm not going to go into a ton of detail on that as I've done it quite a bit on my Clone Trooper build series, which you could check out. Basically, I cleaned up all the printed parts using some Bondo and a ton of sanding. I used Kryolan spray paints for the white and the green, and I used silver rub and buff for all the silver parts. Check out my Clone Trooper painting and my Clone Trooper weathering video for tips and tricks on those two processes, but basically for the weathering, I just did some light washes, some dry brushing for some dirt, and some final airbrushing just for some contouring. There are a few parts that are custom to this build. The first is the eye. I wanted to have a clear lens in there, so I bought these little clear plastic Christmas ornament halves. I dremeled and sanded it down until it fit into the socket and then covered it up with the little printed half eyelid piece. The visor here is pretty cool too. I printed out the main block and then covered it with a welder's mask cut to shape. This will give it a nice glassy finish to look more like a real visor. Plus, I can mount the lights to the back through this hole, which will look pretty much like the movie. We also need to add some tubing around the neck here to fill out this space and give it that L3 look. I installed some mounts in the base of the neck. The larger holes are for convoluted tubing, which will run up to the top of the neck piece. I have some smaller holes here as well to route some larger gauge wire. I also printed some internal hoops to string some of that same wire through the head to hang down. With all of this installed, we're ready to give L3 her first full test. L3.
What?
What time is it?
The time is 8:16 p.m.
L3.
What?
Who is Darth Vader?
Darth Vader is a Dark Lord of the Sith, formerly a Jedi Knight named Anakin Skywalker, and the father of Luke and Leia.
L3.
What?
Execute Order 66.
I don't know that one.
Yeah, that's right, you don't. I think that's going to do it for this video. Thanks for watching. If there is any interest in an Amazon Voice Services Raspberry Pi tutorial, let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to go through all the process with you. Be sure to hit subscribe for updates on this project and some of my other projects, and I will see you next time.
Goodbye.